Okay.
I was actually just gonna go around and, like, start talking with people to get stuff set up for the house on the hill.
Alright, fair enough.
I think I've got a pretty good idea what this keep's worth.
Sig's there.
Oh.
He says, I think we all need to have a discussion.
Or we can all have group discussions.
How did Sig just appear?
Because he's been with you guys the whole time.
Oh, well, I never heard Sig goes into the room, Sig goes here, or Sig goes there.
Well, you also haven't heard Sildar coming with us.
Yeah, me too. Yeah, that.
Sildar's just kind of...
Anyway, so...
Or Rex, or...
So he looks at Sig and he says, wait, what?
Well, I mean, you guys want to go after that cult, right?
I mean,
Blackstick says, yeah, and I can work on that later.
I'm just saying, we need to have a group discussion. It won't
take that. Of
yes,
that.
Yes, about that.
Alright, is everybody okay discussing that over a beer and a smoke? I haven't had a smoke in like 3 days, guys, Blackstick says.
Yeah,
why didn't you just smoke on the cart right here?
I just haven't. I don't know, I forgot.
Drink sounds good.
I've been thinking
for a while.
Blackjack says, ever since hearing that some of this other information, I've had a lot of other things on my mind.
Well, now you have a fancy pipe to smoke out.
Yeah, I've already used it once.
Yes, you have.
And I appreciate it, by the way. I won't forget it.
Yeah, if you find some nice carpenter tools, hook me up.
I will keep that in mind, actually. Blackjack makes a mental note for nice carpenter tools. So we go to the inn?
We go to the inn!
Go to the Stonehill Inn, the same one you've been in?
Yep, the classic.
All right,
it's our base of operations.
It's about as busy as it normally is. There's plenty of room for you guys there.
We find a couple tables and scooch them together, because there's like freaking 7 of us.
Yep.
If they're square tables.
I think there's 8, actually.
I was wondering that, but I think there's...
Because Rex is here, too.
Oh, yeah. Okay, there is 8, yeah.
Whoa.
And you all sit down at the table. I presume you all order some ale or beer or something.
Yep.
Yep.
Some kind of drink.
How much is it?
Yep.
1 silver.
1 silver. Fancy beer.
Yes, they're actually... They're pulling out their nice stuff for you guys because they like you, and they also know you pay for it. So, okay,
funny.
So Sig says, "Well, I can tell you some things about the organization. I don't know if it's, in fact, I don't think I can tell you much more than you guys figured out from that guy that you interrogated. Let's see, you found out from him." A lot of stuff.
No, I got it.
So you found out from the guy that you interrogated that they had a place in Icewind Dale, correct?
Blackjack looks at the rest of the people. Out of character, I actually have this written down, and Blackjack knows, but he looks at the other characters.
I wasn't around for that.
Yeah, that sounds right. It would just be Lazarus that wouldn't know, because he's with the dwarves.
Yeah, but Blackjack does look at Zhang. That's actually what he does. Well,
let's just get a refresher and just go through everything as if we have no idea what's going on. Just so we know.
Is that an out-of-character thing?
No, the Zing saying that in-character.
Okay.
I also have a map for a portion of Icewind Dale.
Oh, you do?
Yeah.
Where'd you get a portion? Where'd you get that map?
From way back, okay. It was in a book.
That's part of Luskan, not part of Icewind Dale.
Oh. Whoops.
Wah, wah, wah.
I'm awful at remembering.
Oh, on that note, Blackjack would actually ask Lazarus, and this is out of character. There's a book that you had that I was interested in, and I can't remember it. I don't know if it was the same book or not.
It was
in script.
It is. It's the same book.
It's the same book. Blackjack would quickly have, at some point in time when we were traveling, he would have asked you what that book is, what's about.
Chris?
You can tell him what I told you.
It's sort of how to operate the, thing that you got.
The thing that I have?
Yeah, the thing. You know.
Yeah, so he...
The thing.
Out of character, the thing being the magic item box thing?
Yes, yes.
Okay, so... Okay. Blackjack would essentially... He wouldn't just, like, ask for it, but he would want it. I don't know how to put it, because he's not, like, somebody who really wants a lot of things.
I mean, I could read it and figure out how to use it. I don't really get the arcane side of it, but
yeah,
I think someone else can supplement for that.
Yeah, Blackjack would tell you that he would be able to worry about the reading part. He's been getting some inklings and been getting some very good vibes from learning these languages and writing this invisible.
No. I mean the not that. I mean like the actual forging part.
What about it?
Like I can do that part. That's probably not going to be that hard to figure out. But I'm going to need like someone else to supplement the magic.
Yeah, but what Blackjack is saying, Blackjack can do the magic, and Blackjack can also do the rest of it, too.
You know how to forge a weapon.
Blackjack thinks about it for a moment. And he said, well, he would be honest and say, the one of the things that I'm not proficient with is Smith's tools. But...
You are not a master blacksmith.
Yeah. But, you know, if the guidebook shows me how, then I can do it. I can figure it out. I am a jack of all trades. Our hot water and soy oil. That's off the bundle.
He's making tea.
Okay. Cool.
Well, okay.
I'm not looking to argue a bunch over it. I'll even buy it from you if you want me to. I just want to have everything together in one unit. And you I've got plans. That.
Well,
I've got plans for all of my tools. I've got a good idea. I've got some good ideas that I want to be surprised.
Just so long as you don't die with the book while you're gone.
All right, that sounds good. Cool.
He hands off the book, but the guy can't read.
Yep. And Blackjack would actually ask you, seriously though, do you want payment, even just as collateral?
Well,
in case I die?
You know, now that you say that,
here, I'll give you 50 gold for the property. And Blackjack hands him the 50 gold. He kind of says it like not quite smart-assly, just like a friendly joke. You know, like he saved him the 50 gold and then he gave him 50 more.
I mean, I was fine just paying for it, but I mean, if you die, I mean,
this is
it's still gonna pay for it, so sure.
Yeah. That's true.
It's like if you die before you get the deal done. Oh well.
Yeah, that'll work. That'll do it.
Okay.
I didn't even think of it that way. Okay, so we can get going. I'm sorry.
So,
forgive me. I'm lame.
Discuss the cult. So, according to the guy that you interrogated, and the group I belong to, the Cult of Nine Demons has nine sections, and each is headed by a powerful being.
Yep.
The prisoner that you guys had said that they are actually demons, which it fits with our scouts' conjectures, but we don't have any proof of it. We also found out a week ago that one of these sections is an assassination section, and they leave calling cards behind.
What's
and
the...
I think there might have been, I can't remember off the top of my head, this is Sig not remembering, but there was some, they leave a particular object behind when they kill someone.
Blackjack, Blackjack makes a very quick look to Lazarus, and it is a fairly stern look.
Now, your prisoner said that they have a shadowy leader of some sort. We didn't know they had a leader at all until he said that. But he seemed to be telling the truth. I mean, you guys had him like in a truth zone or something, right? I think you said?
We actually, at that time, I don't believe we had him in a truth zone. We worked some legal magic on him.
Oh, well, we don't have any reason to disbelieve what he said.
Yeah, because if he didn't tell the truth, he wouldn't have died.
So that, yes, we don't have any reason to disbelieve.
It wasn't quite a zone of truth. It was like a, I don't know. Blackjack is...
It's just a consequence of the magic that he was on.
Yeah, it is.
He was telling truth under contract.
It was logical. It was logically the truth.
The next thing he said is that there was a haven somewhere in Icewind Dale, which we already knew there was. They had some kind of base up there. In fact, we have at least a rough idea of where it could be. Now, as for the next part he said, the one he died while saying, we haven't been able to figure out exactly where that could be. Too many places start with an S to just figure that out. So we might not be able to get anything from there.
Blackjack looks at Zhang and he looks almost appreciative of it.
But now, the Icewind Dale. Obviously, you guys are not part of the organization. And I guess I can tell you the organization's name since I'm trying to get you into it. right now, you're part of my my adventuring guild, and we act as a stepping stone for people to get into the Silver Shields, which is the organization that I belong to.
So, like,
what's your guild's name?
Oh, the Shadow Hunters. I can't believe I never told you guys that. My guild is called the Shadow Hunters, and we do stuff for money, but we also act as a stepping stone for the Silver Shields for recruiting purposes. Basically, I go out and find people to join, or at least I think might be able to join. And I found you guys. You guys are talented enough, and you have enough, you know, morals and gumption that you should be able to fit in pretty well.
I mean, we sort of found you, but...
Well, kind of.
Semantics?
I mean, yes, you met me by chance, but after then I started looking seriously at you guys.
Oh. Lazarus turns to Zhang, stares at the ring. Okay.
Zhang makes a look back at him like, what?
Now, right now, but the higher-ups in the Silver Shields have basically said that you guys, you look like you're good enough, so they can make you kind of not, you aren't actually part of the Silver Shields, but if you do something, like if you complete a task, then you will become official members. So you're like unofficial members. You will be unofficial members, but not official until you complete a task. As for what that task is, it'll probably have something to do with the Haven in Icewind Dale. It hasn't been decided yet. They won't tell me.
Okay.
So, assuming you are still interested, it'll probably take a few months for them to come to a decision. It's bureaucracy. They take their time.
Well, I mean, a few months is good enough. I sort of had plans for the next few months, so...
I mean, I heard you guys say you were going to build a clinic here. That'll probably take some time. So you guys can hang out here, do some other research, whatever you feel like you need to do. I heard someone mention a magic box of some kind, maybe play with that. I honestly don't know what you're talking about with it, but hey, that's your business.
But Blackjack asks a question. I'm sorry, but I really want to trust you here, but I need to know, what are you?
Zhang looks at Sieg very, like, nervously all of a sudden.
Well, he was a boy last time we met him, and now he's a man.
Yeah, everybody knows all those little details. I'd like to get that out on the table. It helped me trust you better. I don't really trust people farther than I can throw them. I can't throw people. He shows you his arms.
Yeah, you are kind of noodle.
Not quite noodly out of character, more bony and like...
sickly. Very,
not sickly, dude. Like, I wouldn't even go disease. Over gaunt.
Diseased and jaundice ridden.
Yeah, terrible, terrible thing. You can barely lift those two arms. Holy shit.
I heard him crack as he lifted them.
It's like
you have... Why is this so funny?
Okay.
Okay.
So he says, okay, well, I guess I do owe it to you guys a little bit. I'm sure at least one of you, and he is looking at Zane when he says this, has an idea of what I might be. I'm not human. I look human, but I'm not. I'm pretty sure that's obvious since the last time you saw me. I looked like I was 10.
You're a dragon, aren't you?
Zane says, what color are you?
Blackjack sighs, and Blackjack just says, I just want a direct answer.
Okay.
Are you a doppelganger? Are you a dragon? Are you a dryad? What are
you? I am not a dryad.
Dryads are women.
I am a silver dragon.
Blackjack is satisfied.
Take human form, because if I walk around as a dragon, people try to kill me, or, run terrified because dragon. You know.
I mean, he has a point.
Yeah, I don't think anybody's argued with him. So the point doesn't really matter. Blackjack just says okay. Oops. Oh, Blackjack would like to make an insight check to see if he's telling the truth.
Okay.
Oh, add one to that. Yeah, add one to that.
He appears to be telling the truth.
Okay. Blackjack is satisfied. Simple.
It was, well, I didn't expect you guys to just come out and say that, but yes. So...
Master of Tact Blackjack over here is just straight up bringing it forward, so...
Well, yeah, I mean...
He's frustrated.
It makes
sense. I mean, it was kind of obvious from the second time we met you.
How's that?
You made a dragon run terrified from just saying, I'll come for you in the night.
Well,
not many things can do that besides a really powerful wizard or a dragon.
Well, I dealt with him before. I mean, he's only like 70 years old, so he's pretty young.
And how old are you?
Older than that.
Blackjack lasts a little bit, but not that much.
Fair enough.
Old enough that I could crush him if I wanted to, so let's just leave it at that.
Well, I mean, you could probably crush us and entire town if you want.
Blackjack looks at Lazarus confused.
Why are you insisting that I do violence?
I don't think he's insisting. I think he's just suggesting your capability, that's all. Or reminding of everybody the capability? Blackjack sounds confused.
Well, either way, you have an adventurers guild. We're part of it now. We have a few months of downtime.
Effectively.
Some of us are going to stay back and help build the place. Some might not.
Now you, he's pointing at Blackjack, says, you said you were going to go to Neverwinter, correct?
Yeah. Correct?
And he rustles around in his armor and pulls out a little card and hands it to you.
I read the card. I examine the card.
It has a name on it. It says Sigmund Frostwright on it. It says, that's the name I go by in Neverwinter. When I look like this, that's my name.
Sigmund Frostwright?
Yes.
Okay.
Now... that card will allow you into the Library of Neverwinter.
Interesting, Blackjack says.
And basically it says you have my blessing to go wherever that I can, pretty much. And I can go into the library, so you would be able to go into the library. As long as you don't start, you know, I presume you wouldn't take stuff that isn't yours. That would come back to bite me, so I'd rather eat it.
Blackjack says, I'll keep it in mind.
Yeah, just don't destroy stuff, don't steal stuff. You can read anything, any of the stuff that's not in the restricted sections.
If it's a library, can I not, like, borrow books?
Some books you'll have to ask. It depends on the book. Some of them, they're the only book of their kind, and they don't want to lend them out.
What's your position in the town?
Well, I don't actually work for Neverwinter, but they know who I am, to a degree, some more than others.
Yeah, and, so why do you have such a lofty position in the city? What do you do for the city?
I help them from time to time when they need help with certain things.
He runs an adventurer's guild.
My guild does help the city occasionally. There are two other groups than you guys. You obviously are the newest group. There is the gold group and the silver group. You can choose whatever your name you want to be for your group.
I turn to everybody else.
Never really thought of a group name for us.
Blackjack will actually make a stab at something, and well, he's getting ready to make a stab. He's thinking.
Well, you guys can have whatever name you want, as long as it's not something that'll make people kill you on sight or something. But I'm in charge of the silver group. The gold group's in charge of one of my subordinates, my right-hand guy. And we do stuff for Neverwinter occasionally. I apparently have done enough stuff over the years that they like me a lot. So I do have permission to go quite a few places that people can't. That will give you permission for the library and a few other places, but just the library for now, please.
Blackjack doesn't say anything else to that statement.
You said something earlier that has me curious.
What's that?
You said that they left a calling card?
Blackjack turns and looks at... He turns and looks at Lazarus sternly again.
I mean, you told me, but I can't remember what it is. It's some... They leave an object behind as a calling card. And that's really a line. It's like a something I can't quite place. I can't remember what it is. If something were to jog my memory, I might remember, but...
Blackjack opens his hand in front of Zhang.
Zing looks into the hand and kind of looks like he's been dreaming or something, like daydreaming.
There's nothing in the hand.
Magic!
There's nothing in my hand!
Sorry, what did you want, Blackjack?
Oh, me? Nothing. Sorry. Blackjack says.
I mean, if you knew what it was, or figured, if you guys remember what it says, I'd actually, Well, I guess you don't have to tell me. It's probably written down somewhere, because I wrote down what you guys told me. It's just not on me, and I can't remember off the top of my head.
Why?
We've got some things we will need to investigate ourselves as well. Don't worry.
Yeah,
I'd like to make an insight check on what he said, to see if he actually has it written down, or if he's using that as a way to try and get it out of us.
Okay. Wow, that's interesting.
Let's make an insight check.
Blackjack don't care. He ain't saying nothing. Specifically. I'm trying to send vibes Lazarus's way. I'm trying to send the vibes.
Yeah, he's unsure.
Yeah.
Because you don't know nothing about it, but he's wondering if it pertains to his uncle.
Well,
Well, maybe the face thingies are out of character. Okay.
I see.
I don't know. There's two sets of stuff.
From what you can tell, he is, he probably does have it written down somewhere.
I still don't say anything.
Lazarus actually pulls out a small cage that has a broken mechanical canary in it.
Mm. Whoa. I forgot about that out of character. I don't even remember where it's from.
From my backstory.
Oh, okay.
Where did you get that?
It was found with my uncle.
Hmm.
But it was apparently with my parents whenever I was found by him. So...
And it was broken at that time, too?
It might not have been broken then, but whenever he found it, it was.
I tried to fix it once. What happened when I tried to fix it?
It's magic.
Oh, it's magical?
The thing is mending normally can heal some magic items?
No,
I think
no,
it's at some.
No, that's fine. I just didn't realize. I forgot it was magic.
Oh, yeah, it is.
I just wanted to remember why I couldn't fix it, because I think I tried.
You did.
You can physically repair a magic item or construct, but you can't restore it to its previous condition. But you didn't actually manage to even physically repair this one.
No, yeah, that's fine.
And he says, well, I think that's a lyre bird.
A lyre bird?
Lyre with an L-I-A or L-Y-R?
Like the instrument. It's used to dictate and record things. You can also use it to record people when they don't know it and stuff like that.
Your uncle's unfortunate demise. Blackjack kind of stutters when he says all this because he knows where he's going with this.
No, it was from before then.
Oh.
If that can be repaired, you might be able to hear whatever's stored in it. But there are tricky things. I mean, it's in a gnomish thing for a reason. The gnomes are the people who make stuff like that. So you probably have to find a gnome master smith who knows how to repair magic items.
I could take it with me on my travels.
There's one in Neverwinter. Personally, I don't believe there is one. You can look. Maybe there is one, and I don't know.
Yeah, but anyway, Blackjack will say, and if you don't want me to, that's understandable, and it's no worries.
I'll keep it with me for now.
But if you find someone to repair that, you can probably find out what was recorded on it.
If I do find somebody, I'll keep an ear out, and if I do find somebody, then I'll let you know.
Thanks.
Yeah, of course.
I mean... That is an interesting artifact there. They're pretty rare. Incredibly complicated. I mean, you haven't tried to, like, take it apart or anything, have you?
No, I'm not really good with.
If you do that, you might mess up what's in it, so don't.
Blackjack says, actually, while it's not necessarily my specialty in the big scheme of things, because I specialize in a lot of things, I am quite proficient with Tinker's Tools. I have learned a thing or two. Now, that's not me committing to doing anything with that, because mostly just because it's also magical, but I do know some magic stuff. But I understand, no worries.
But the complexity of this device is far beyond most people. I mean, I could not hope to fix it at all. I know a fair amount of stuff about magic items. I couldn't repair stuff, though, so I guess that's not saying much.
Alright, well... Thanks.
Out of character, I am proficient with Tinker Tools.
That means you can make and repair small mechanical objects, basically.
Yep. I also have the mending, I also have, I've got quite a few different things that I could throw at that. But I would not want to risk breaking it, in all honesty. Only if Lazarus asked me to try something. I'll let him know I may have some stuff, but only if he asks me.
The wait will probably be about 2 or 3 months. It might be a little longer. It depends on how long they keep talking about stuff. They don't include me on their little conversations, so I'm not sure.
Out of character, the longer it is, the cooler. It's like 3 months is just enough time to get stuff done, but like 6 months would be enough time to get stuff done and like do other stuff.
Hey, Chris.
Yeah.
I sent you something over Discord that's super private, confidential, and do with it what you will.
That you posted on the YouTube video?
Some Discord over Discord.
Well,
he posted something over Discord, yeah.
Please change your name from Music Bob.
That's the name of the bot.
Yeah.
I'm not talking about him.
Wait, why is my name Music Bob? Who changed my name?
I don't think he ever changed it back.
I never changed it to Music Bob.
Someone
I swear.
Else.
Someone changed everyone's names to Music Bob like a while
ago. Oh, I thought everyone was changing everyone's
well,
name.
Well, no, everyone was.
Somebody changed yours, apparently.
How do you you can change somebody else's name?
No, he probably had, there's probably an admin.
Well, I don't think anyone can change anyone's nickname.
No, well,
only two people here can change people's nicknames.
Okay, so it was either you or
I just
Arthur.
Admitted to it.
Okay.
And as he admitted.
I changed yours.
I can't change, oh wait, here we go.
And I changed Jacob's to Music Bob. So everyone
like
was
all
Music
of them
Bob.
Get changed at once. I'm like, ah, everybody's in. It's really funny.
It was.
I said, why is my name Music Bob?
Yeah.
So, 3 months, maybe. That's enough time.
Yeah, you said it's 2 or 3 months. It might be a little longer. It just depends on how long things get drawn out, because they like to talk about stuff. In debate.
Bojack says, yeah, that's fine. That gives me enough time to do some legwork.
Yeah, you guys can do more research, build your clinic, maybe other things, I don't know.
Oh, how are things in Amphail?
Everything seemed to be just fine there, really.
Alright, cool.
I gave them the money, they seemed very happy with it.
Please carry it. He sends them back the money.
Are you headed back down that way anytime soon?
Actually, I'm not headed that direction at all. And probably not for some time. You probably won't see me again until you guys are... till the decision has been made. However, let's see, Sildar here.
Yeah, Sildar and Rez, are you guys...
Sildar will, I believe he told me he was going to, he'll stay here if he has a place to stay, otherwise he'll be a Neverwinter. And Rex said that he was going to stay here because it's a nice quiet place, and he wants to get away for a while, is what he said. I'm pretty sure there's some ulterior motives there, do not know what they are.
Yeah, but everybody's here at the table. He says ulterior motives in front of Rex. Anyways, so Blackjack X Sildar, he says, you know, if you're going to Neverwinter, I'm also going. Do you mind joining up just in case we can, you know, help each other out?
Sildar says, yeah. I can go with you to Neverwinter. I mean, I don't
just
think we're running any
travel.
Trouble on the roads.
We never know. That's all.
I mean, the main roads normally pretty safe. But yeah, there's no reason
cool.
not to. Just for precaution.
Now then,
especially since I have my sword back.
Awesome, and your armor. So Sig, do you have anything else for us?
Well, not really. Unfortunately.
Do you mind if us four talk in private then?
Oh yeah. I'll leave. I need to be on my way anyway.
And Sildar, I'll meet you outside on the edge of town in a few hours. Is that all right with you?
Yeah, that's fine with me.
Cool.
I'll meet you out there and we can start heading off.
Whenever it's just the four of us,
yep.
there's money to be given out.
There's money to be given out, Blackjack says. Anyway, it's just
for
the four. No, it's just the five of us. Yeah, we already gave the money out for the chest.
This is from before the other guy joined.
No, but there's five of us right now is what I'm saying.
Okay, well...
Yeah.
You can split he can watch money be split in front of him.
I said four, but I really meant the five of us. I guess, yeah. Because the Dragonborn. So, how do you split out the money? What monies do we get?
A lot of money.
A lot?
He pulls out a pouch and gives one to each person, aside from himself. Well, including himself. So, a pouch is given to Blackjack, Albrecht, and Zane.
How much money is in Blackjack's pouch?
Oh boy. There is 402 gold.
What? Are you serious?
Yep.
Wow, I can barely lift it. It's like 10-pound bag. You said 402?
Yep.
Out of character, where the hell did you get this money?
I've had loot.
Holy shit.
He's been keeping the majority of the money that he finds.
Wow-wee. Because he kept giving us some. Cool. This is cool. It's cool.
Lazarus is just like, bitch, I came back from Tunica. What do you want from me?
So, 402 gold.
Oh, my.
107 silver pieces.
107? There's more, you say?
Yeah, there's more, bitch!
Just a sec. 107. So that's 200.
I'll just type it out. I will just type it out.
And how much copper?
That's not right.
1,600 copper?
No, that much?
275 copper, good lord.
Is that how this much is everyone's funny. Getting?
This is
That's
so
how much
funny.
Everyone but Starkum is getting.
So are you just giving everyone all of your money or something?
No. I have loot.
Yeah, he has loot, I guess. Holy cow, this is sweet. Like, that's like double my money.
Double my money.
Yeah. But...
Yeah, that's a really high amount. This is before you're selling stuff, too?
No, that was after.
I don't know. This is nice.
That was after.
I'm not going to argue. I'm not arguing, you guys.
Okay. When did you find time to sell all this?
We were at Neverwinter once or twice. But
you guys selling all those dang weapons you found and stuff.
I didn't know we got that much for all of that. I thought I did most of the selling on that end. But this works.
This is a shit ton of money.
Yeah. And Albrecht gets 3 diamonds. Worth 100
gold
pieces.
Are they each worth
100
gold? Yes.
They are each worth 100 gold pieces each. Man.
Yeah, it's like I gave you. It's like I gave you guys diamonds on purpose so you could use the spell once or twice. I mean.
Well, I only remember us ever getting a set of 3. So.
We also got 4 diamonds that were worth 30 each. Those were
rinky dink ones.
We also had some other gems, but those were sold.
Holy cow. I don't even know what to do with all this money. I know I'm going to do what I'm getting Neverwinter. I'm going to exchange it all for platinum pieces. And
just remember, some places might not want platinum pieces.
That's why I'm going
to like Amphale. Amphale would not want platinum pieces.
I don't need to carry that. I don't know. I kind of disagree with the don't want thing. Because, I mean, if they have plenty of gold, then they can easily exchange.
It'd be like walking into Walmart with a solid gold piece. They would be like, we can't accept this.
No, it wouldn't. It'd be like walking into Walmart with, like, a $100 bill or the highest bill denomination.
Seen, like, a lot of stores will say they don't take, like, gas stations in particular is what I'm thinking. They say they don't take 50s or 100s. That's the same sort of concept.
No, yeah, I understand that because they don't necessarily have the change to be able to be that flexible.
Well, it's not really that. It's more like a town like Phandalin probably has, like, maybe 300 gold in, like, the city coffers. Maybe.
Just for your information, when Blackjack went to the the number 9 on the map, the Lion Shield Coster, he took pretty much all of their platinum from them.
No, I didn't. All my platinum was exchanged in the Neverwinter, I think.
Yeah, it was. There was an exchange rate. He was pissed about it.
No, I never had an exchange rate. It was direct.
Well, someone got platinum.
Somebody got screwed on the exchange rate. I remember
that. That was me. That was me.
Out of character, somebody told me out of character, and I was like, oh, well, that's good that you got platinum, though.
But... There is probably more gold on this table than this town probably has in its entirety.
Yeah, we load up and we
it's
quietly
all in bags and stuff though, right?
Yeah, we put it all the way in the bags. We just write down exactly how much you tell us. We assume that you're telling us the accurate number of gold.
It is the accurate truth.
That seems redundant. The accurate... What's the inaccurate truth, then? Is that alternative facts?
Exactly.
Oh, anyway.
But still, that's a shit ton of money.
Alright, so yeah, shit ton of money. Got it, check. But finally, there's this other issue that we gotta talk about. How much is that place worth?
So, just to make sure, it is just the four of us in here at this point.
No, it's five of us.
I mean,
but,
forgot the Dragonborn, but yes.
In your group, it's just the five of you.
Okay, I'd say I have a pretty good idea of how much it's worth.
Do you say something about the just to make sure, blah, blah, blah?
That's out of character.
Oh, okay. Yeah,
I was making sure that, so we didn't have another situation where we forget the kids with us or whatever.
Okay, yeah, then Blackjack would just do a double check. He's really wanting to get this closure, but he is going to double check to make sure that he's out of earshot of anybody like super duper important or interesting, especially Sildar. Babushka.
Okay, so...
Is Sildar out of here?
Yeah, Sildar is not in the building.
Okay.
So a full build keep, like if it was completely finished, would be 50,000. But this is in a lot of damage, so value-wise, it'd be from anywhere from 20,000 to 25,000. But that's not what we're going to be able to sell it for. I would say if we did some good haggling, we can get up to 20,000.
Okay. So, I'm going to be up front here, and yeah, you noticed there's some interesting exchanges back at the Town Master Hall. The answer to anybody's question is yes, it only has my name on it, and I'm being upfront with you about it. You do want to build the thing here. He looks at Lazarus real briefly, and that's all fine. That's super duper cool, which is pretty much met the intent, actually, of why I only put my name on it. So the intent of only putting my name on it is if the poo were to hit the fan, I could negotiate individually from everybody else. And the only reason that to do so is essentially against insurance. No offense, Lazarus, but there have been a few times where you've jumped the gun and missed a little bit of tact, and so that was just basically going to let me have control over the situation if I needed to break in case of emergency. Seeing it won't be here, it's not a big deal. So you essentially bought insurance for yourself and didn't know it by being interested in investing in this building. But I was putting my name specifically on there just to buy insurance. And if you want to out of character, if you want to roll any insight check for his truth, tell it, go ahead.
Yeah.
But he's saying, you know, while you guys start your work here, I can go take care of business in town. It may take me a little bit longer because I would like to take care of a few things that I didn't know about. I may want to just take a brief few looks, so I may be in Neverwinter for a few days. So my plan is to go to Neverwinter. So let me get this straight. You think we could sell it for maybe 20,000 gold?
With some haggling.
With haggling, yeah. Well, I'm going for 22.
You can try for that. I would say we can get about 20,000.
Yeah, I understand. I will see what I can do. I think there'll be a few good key points. And I'm going to see if I can get them to see our point of view. Luckily we have a few friends there. We know a few names. He winks. We have quite a few good reasons. So I've got a lot of leverage here. I think this is Blackjack thinking out loud, not to give the DM any help, but to show the DM that Blackjack knows already some of the downsides, is that there aren't going to necessarily be that many buyers. But another interesting point is that you have two possible interested buyers. Out of character, I just don't like giving the DM all my firepower, but Blackjack would say, we've got quite a few good things going for us on this deal. We do have the simple fact that we're preferring Neverwinter over the Lord's Alliance, and we can explain that to them, but the Lord's Alliance would also be interested in it. We're doing them a favor by letting them have essentially a first bid on it, possibly the only bid. We are doing this for the best interest of the mine to reintroduce the mining capability. If we give it to them, they will see a lot more market. It'll be good for the economy. There's whole lots more things, you know. So I think we've got a pretty good list, and I'll probably think about this list when I'm traveling. We have a pretty good list. So with that in mind, I estimated at somewhere between 10 and 30K. I wasn't sure, honestly. But your estimate seems to be pretty good. And I think I'm going to try to push it as high as I can go. But I, you know, I don't want to offend anybody. But if the deal does go really sour, we can always go to Lord's Alliance. And I think, Lazarus, I know you don't mind that. I don't think everybody else minds that. I don't think everybody else wants that. But if the deal goes sour, that's kind of how I would lean. And by sour, I mean it's got to go way bad. I want to try to get as much money out of it as I can. But, I mean, if we're talking a difference of 1,000 gold, I'm still probably interested in selling to Neverwinter. If we're talking a difference of 5 or 6,000 gold, that's kind of where I would lean going the other way. So that's kind of where I stand on it. What are you guys' thoughts and opinions?
Yeah, if you're getting an obvious vibe like they're about to screw us, then I would say that's probably a good idea.
Yeah. Either way works.
I know you have a differing opinion, Lazarus. On the
I wouldn't say that you should let money in this case influence your decision. If Waterdeep is really as bad as you say, which I don't know.
I think for me it's the difference of you can do a lot more good with that kind of money.
This is very much true.
But but like I said, I am more interested in selling it to Neverwinter, trust me. You don't have to worry about that.
On that note, we have money. It's going to take money to build the clinic. How do we want to do that? Are people interested in buying into it? If you're not, that's completely fine. I will still let you sleep in the house part of it.
Y'all buy in.
Blackjack? Oh, sorry.
How much cash do you need for this thing?
At the moment, I don't know, because we just sort of came up with the idea.
We can talk after I get back from Neverwinter, maybe?
Yeah. I should have a good estimate then, and I should be able to find it. Yeah, just after you get back, but...
I'm going to be a really good construction worker, let me tell you that. And Zing holds up his gauntlets of overpower and flexes them.
That's not so much... I have a better job for you.
And Albrecht. Logs.
Zing makes
You're
going
to be picking up planks. Until we get all the wood that we need.
Blackjack says, now what about him? And he kind of points to Sarkam.
Oh, he comes.
I'm really unsure about
him. He can come with us.
No, not whether or not he comes with us, or goes with you to build the building.
I'm just...
takes a sip.
I think maybe he could say what he's going to do.
No, I mean, like, splitting the money. Where do you guys stand on that?
Sarkam speaks up and says, I don't need any.
Doesn't need any.
Blackjack says, well, there it is.
He did not make us make the decision. Let's, made it himself.
Let's just help him out, and if he needs something, we'll give him the cash for it. But otherwise, let's just worry about what we've got going and try to settle our own affairs.
We'll split it four ways evenly when we...
Also, no offense to, like, not cutting you in on the gold. I just really didn't want to have to do the math for cutting it five ways, because I already did it four ways, and it was supposed to be a surprise and stuff.
That's fine.
Like, I already had the bags.
Blackjack does say, if you'd like, and this is up to you, I don't really mind one way or the other, but I'll keep it in mind if you guys want. What I can do is get a receipt so you guys can see that the gold that I'm bringing, I'm not screwing anybody over.
That's a good idea. I'd say just for our records.
All right, I can do that. Just so that you can see a receipt of sale. I just being straightforward with you, you know, if somebody to go fetch the money for me, I would really expect and want some sort of official receipt. Out of character, I could totally forge it, but I'm not going to.
Oh yeah, like
I just
that was the first thing that went through my head.
Now.
I was like,
I realized it just now.
If this bitch ever gets caught doing that, he's losing more than his head.
I mean, it wouldn't be that unlikely considering he's already signed the deed off to himself and everything. He could just take it all.
Well, actually, I could just go to Neverwinter and never come back. You'd never see me again. But anyway, that's a different point.
We'd find you.
Not necessarily. It's not like you leave the money.
Arthur makes the Liam Neeson voice. We will find
you. It's not like you can't scry people.
Yeah, or objects. Yeah. Like the deed.
Anyway. No. Just... scry this chess piece. It's weird. Probably
it's weird. That's
one of a kind.
It's weird.
It's like a ruby chess piece. Probably one of a kind. Griffin.
Anyway, well, actually, it's not. It's not one of a kind. But Blackjack does look at you, and he does appreciate. He says, thank you, by the way, for not mentioning too much stuff.
Mentioning what?
Too much stuff.
I saw you giving me, like, dirty looks, and I'm still really not sure why you were giving me dirty
looks, Blackjack says, although I can see how they would be taken that way.
I'm still
that's,
really
that's
confused.
That's the look of, that's my look of pause and think for a moment and pause some more.
I don't even know why you were giving me that look.
Because I don't know what you know, and I don't know what you don't know, and I had to assume that you do know.
I can safely say that I don't know about a lot of things.
You know what I know, because I can't keep my freaking mouth shut.
Hey, same.
You do a pretty decent job, Zang.
Zang tries.
I'll give you a comparison. Days. I'll give you a comparison grade. Anyway,
Alright, well, you have like a few hours of staying in Phandalin before you're getting the hell out of town, so... enjoy the ride to Neverwinter?
Yeah. Blackjack pulls out his pipe, his brand new pipe, and he like was like...
don't get mugged on the way?
I'm traveling with Sildar, so it shouldn't be so bad.
Okay, you say that, but we were traveling with Sildar.
You have
a
point.
All I know about this guy is that he's been captured recently, so I don't have the most trust in him.
We were traveling with Sildar, and then all of a sudden goblins happened, and then things.
And then suddenly he was, like, down on the ground, bleeding out, and dragged through a forest.
Yeah,
so,
you're right.
I'm not going to put as much confidence in his ability to not suck it up.
But anyways, there's more than one of us. It's not just me traveling by myself. And I have made
better
along the from Waterdeep to Neverwinter already. Although I'll give you that road is much more traveled, more well traveled than the road we're going on to get to that road.
Okay.
So, you should see me back maybe in a week or two, I think.
Yeah. Also,
he gave me a month, right?
Yeah. Also, out of character, it's funny that you, like, bargaining for the house actually didn't save me any money. in the long scheme of things.
Why didn't it?
Because that was just going to be factored into the 900 gold.
Into what 900 gold?
The total cost of the thing.
That's just...
The total cost of the build?
Yep. Yeah.
Why would that be factored into that?
Because that's part of it when you look at it in the DM guide.
Yeah.
What do you mean?
If you look at building...
Building a house or whatever.
Yeah?
That's part of the cost.
Well, I mean, wouldn't that mean you would knock that off the cost
now? Yeah, you would knock that part off the cost. Definitely. Like, Jacob,
you're still spending the money for it before you do the cost.
No, what
no, you but you're not.
That's what I'm saying. He still would be spending it, but he got it negotiated out of there, so yeah. It's less.
Yeah.
It's still 50 gold that goes somewhere else now.
No, it's not even 50 gold that goes somewhere else. It's 50 gold that's not spent on it. Period.
Like, logically, that just doesn't make sense. It costs 900 with that, and then you get rid of that. How does it suddenly still cost 900?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Potato. It is his call.
Yeah, but okay, so what we're saying, though, just so we're all on the same page, Joe.
I understand. I understand. But it was just one of those. At the time, he told me that it was 900, and that factors everything in, and it was one of those, oh. And then later on, he told me, oh yeah, it might cost gold for the land. I was like, ah, well, hey, that's factored into the 900. So it's one of those net, like, nothing's really gained or lost.
Well,
that doesn't make any sense. So going just from point A to point B in the logic here, basically, is if you said for all land and everything total, work, labor, and whatever fees, government fees, you say it's 900 gold, right? And you buy it. Okay, it's 900 gold. Now, if you say in advance, you're either getting 50 gold off of the land or you're getting 50 gold off of the government fees or getting 50 gold off of something else, it's still 50 gold off. So then at the end of the day, it's 850.
Yeah, if he said it was included, then he should only be charging you 850. Unless he changes his mind, which he can do, but...
Let me put it this way. Whatever you guys paid for it would be subtracted off the 900 because you already paid it.
So,
you paid
for the land.
The 50 is already paid for because it was negotiated out.
Right, so technically we only have to pay the 850 to bring it up to the 900 because we've technically paid for it through negotiation.
Yeah.
So there's only an 850 bill remaining.
And that's, I don't know if that's just labor or if that's labor and everything else or if that's just material.
The original numbers without all the discounts that have already been applied here.
What?
That's so far back.
I don't know what all it costs, but all I know is that if you're charging 50 more because we got a disc, because we were able to talk our way into having the land free, then that doesn't make any sense.
Well, that just means that there's 50 more gold of amenities. Maybe we'll have, like, a working bathroom.
But that's different, right? So that's...
Wishful thinking.
Gold of... whatever. I mean, working bathroom, blah, blah, blah. 50 more gold of amenities is 50 more gold worth of stuff.
That's like $1,000 off your truck. What they really mean is $1,000 of amenities you can put into it. You're not getting a discount. You're just saying, oh, you don't have to spend that money.
Can we put a portal in the toilet so we never have to clean it?
Do you want to know?
Technically, yes.
We did figure out how much gold it would cost to have a portal, like a permanent teleportation circle. Maybe.
How much gold is that?
200,000?
That sounds like a question. You sounded very sure about what that number was.
No, it's like 200,000.
There you go.
What would it cost to employ somebody for the rest of their lives and our lives to open a portal every time we needed it? Would it be less?
No, it would be more because then it wouldn't be.
How many times you need a portal?
That's true.
Yeah, true. Yeah. We're talking.
You have to get on the schedule.
Economics.
Just two portals a day, max. You better hold it. everyone gets on the same schedule, then we're in business.
I really want a toilet portal.
Literally.
You get a chamber pot.
It's gross. I want a toilet portal.
Okay, my
problem with that is, where's the portal lead out?
Yeah, that's the funny thing. It leads somewhere in like some god's palace or something, or some ethereal domain, or blah blah blah.
Because then things could enter it and go into our toilet.
In the secret section of that library.
Or if it's only in one direction. I mean, if it's a unit, I'm pretty sure there's a unidirectional portal.
There is.
Just put it way up in the sky so that nobody can reach it, except birds, and then that gets weird.
It rains poop. It's up in the sky because
there's a patch of ground that has like bright flowers and vines and stuff growing under like it. This
big dude, tower. Be worse than that. What if found birds going in the other side?
No, but it's a one way. We already talked about
it. So we did the math, and I think we decided that it was going to be 1,300 normally.
For what?
And then for like all the stuff for the house. And because I'm cutting down like 300 and...
Oh, you'll have plenty of money to do that.
No, because I'm cutting down 350 trees, we're saving 469 gold.
Oh, I see what you're saying. That's cool. That's cool you guys did the math. I appreciate that.
Yeah, it was a very long call, like...
Saying, roll comment check every time you need to...
It was from...
I'm laughing too hard.
Oh, no, it was 1,300 gold at beginning with 469.
And you fart feathers.
Yeah, this is the math that we did.
A five-year-old.
I believe your math. That's funny.
It was a very, like, good, no. Gross. Nasty.
You fart feathers.
Poof. Yeah, it was like 1,300 minus 469. So that's like 831, but we raised it up to 900 for extra.
Just to be sure.
Yeah, because that was just like land, lumber, building it. It wasn't including like furniture and like furnishing.
Okay, so just asking, because I really, out of character, I really want to get to this point. What do we have to do to get to the point where we're doing other stuff? Because we're not quite there, right? So I have to go to Neverwinter and get the thing sold.
Yes.
Is that the only thing that we have to do to get to, and then we all have to like either say goodbyes or do whatever we're going
to
do.
Well, you guys have to get to where you're doing like more questing stuff, right? That's what you're talking about.
No. I'm asking about where do we get to do the downtime stuff, because when we get there, we can do the downtime stuff offline, essentially, or not on Rule 20. We can do that kind of for the next week or whatever.
Okay, like, well...
over the course of the week.
Basically, you guys need to... Well, actually, the building of the clinic can be done...
during that time, yeah.
Yes. The only thing that needs to be done, really, is you going to Neverwinter, yeah.
Okay, just checking. So then I will go ahead and go do that. As a side note, I asked this question a while ago, but not everybody was here, so I got to ask it again. Is everybody okay taking a break 1 week?
Like, yeah, sure.
This next Saturday?
Yeah.
Okay,
cool. For
that'll give us more time to do downtime stuff, because I'm assuming you guys want to do a lot of downtime stuff. I want to do a lot of downtime stuff.
I will say this just for like date-keeping stuff.
Yeah.
During the downtime, two birthdays will happen.
Who's are those?
First is Blackjack's in less than a week.
Wow. Oh, hey.
And you will be turning 44.
All right.
I think I'm turning 51, right?
You are turning 51 in on the 5th of Alight.
We don't have a birthday for Sarkum.
We don't have a birthday for Sarkum. Let's roll a birthday.
Yeah. While you're rolling for the birthday for Sarkum.
I'm back.
Sarkum, roll a d12. That everyone can see. Not just the GM.
So, let me see here.
Ooh, he has the same birth month as... Oh, shit. His birthday might have just came up. Roll a d30. His birthday's, like, in 5 days. Okay.
Fair enough.
It's, like, 4 days before, Blackjacks.
So I gotta go to Neverwinter, then I gotta come back, split money. I thought there was something else that I was thinking of doing before going, but yeah, so I'm gonna go ahead and do that. I'll see you guys in a week or so.
Okay.
I'll go ahead and skip the other stuff, because I can go back, whenever. I go do that, and I'm looking for the most expedient way to get to the people who will give me the deal.
Okay, so once you're there, it takes a couple days to get everything up and running. Like, make sure to get people interested, the two different parties interested.
Two different parties? There's only one party.
Oh, there's Neverwinter. And,
yep, that's the only party I'm talking to.
Okay, you're only talking to Neverwinter.
Yep.
Okay, so then you end up talking with a steward of Neverwinter.
Okie doke. And I would ask him who I need to talk to make this deal.
He is the guy you have to talk to.
He is the guy. Excellent.
Enter the city to buy this keep from you.
And Blackjack would basically tell him, not like this, but it's kind of like, oh man, do I have a deal for you? But not really. Like, I have a really good opportunity for you. So, what's his name? I gotta at least know his name.
Making me come up with names.
Garfield.
There you go, Garfield. Okay, Garfield.
His name's Garfield.
The Deals Warlock.
Yes.
The what?
Garfield, the Deals Warlock.
The Deals Warlock. All right. The Deals Warlock Steward.
Don't deal with him on a Monday, though.
He has his side job on, at, like, Fantasy Costco.
This is good. I like this. Nice improv. Anyways.
That's not improv.
It's just reference. Oh. But I was like, man, this is great. You guys are, like, really killing it.
We're on the same page. Goddamn.
Anyway. Okay. So. Anyway. basically, I tell him, look, we've cleared out a keep. I've got this title to the keep in my name. The local government of Phandalin has signed it to me as proof that I am the owner and current caretaker of this keep. I recently came into it under possession during a fortuitous excavation and examination of the site, removing its former frustrating tenants for the town. And I am looking to sell it to Neverwinter.
Okay, first question. Who was living there?
Who was living there? It was a colorful crowd of goblins.
Okay, so it was infested with goblins.
It was inhabited by goblins.
The goblins were using it as a base.
That is correct.
Okay. And you removed the goblins. Okay, so what state is the...
What state is the what?
What state is the keep in?
The state of the keep, I would estimate, so it has been damaged in several places. I would estimate that it is between one half and two thirds completion. Okay. And yeah, and it has several furnishings already. Some of the furnishings would have to be removed, but it does have several furnishings in good condition. In addition to that, and stone. I mean, you're looking at 5 foot thick wall stone in several places, easily. It has, let me think here. It has quite a few rooms. I think somewhere between 15 and 20, if I'm not mistaken. It has, yeah. I'm trying to think of anything else super important. And that's kind of what I go with for now.
We okay, don't bring up the owlbear infestation around the room.
So he pulls out a map. Where mm-hmm. on the where on the map exactly is this key?
I pull out my map and I show it to him and I locate it for him.
Oh, that's not.
It's in the Neverwinter Wood, south of Neverwinter Wood.
Oh, well, then it makes sense that it should belong to Neverwinter.
Blackjack smiles a little bit knowingly.
Well then, let's see. You successfully cleared. I presume it was you, and it wasn't just you.
Blackjack pauses for a moment, and he says, no, I have a few associates of mine.
Ah, good. If you did it by yourself, I was going to be scared.
Why would you be scared?
That would mean you're quite a powerful individual.
Would that make it worth more or less?
It wouldn't change the value, but it'd make it change other things. Anyway.
You have to have a powerful license to be that powerful.
Anyway, so I need to send someone out there to look at it. It'll only take a couple days. They can get there much faster than normal people.
All right.
They're really good at going fast.
You better trust them to do a quality job then. How trust them to do a quality job if they do it in such a hurry?
Neverwinter Jimmy Johns.
No. They're good at getting there fast. They'll take their time examining it. But they're good at getting there fast, and they'll get back here really fast. Whether it's more
I've had a dwarven expert look over this.
It's more or less that we'll have someone put there fast. But then they will report back.
All right. So then I meet you back here in how many days?
It should be a day and a half or 2 days. It just depends. We'll contact.
You'll contact me?
Yeah, we'll send a runner to get you.
To get me? Okay.
Then we'll meet back here and discuss some money.
All right, sounds good. In the meantime, I'm just assuming the meeting is over. In the meantime, let's see here. Blackjack will go around town because he's got a little bit of time. He's not really going to do much, but he will go around town looking for capable, able, and willing doctors, medics, and clerics.
You find a whole bunch of clerics as far as like herbalists, which are basically what doctors are in D&D for the most part. You find some experienced ones. Most of them have their own little nooks and crannies that they administer their wares and services.
Among them, I would like to put out a general offer to clerics of Shantaea and herbalists and see who is interested in a, I guess, servicing or interested in an interview, servicing at a place where they get free room and board, where they work. And they get compensated for the next 3 months in addition to the normal time that they work there.
Let's see. I have to roll dice for this.
So I'm looking to see how many people are interested in this offer, or interested in an interview.
There are three people interested in an interview.
Well, I let them know that I will be traveling that way in a few days' time, and they can travel with me there, and we'll interview them and see where we can go from there.
Only two of them agree to go with you.
Only two of them?
Why is travel will be compensated.
I told them about the travel.
Well, it's more along the lines of he was hoping you'd make an offer right then.
Oh.
Oh.
So he just tells me no thanks, or does he tell me no thanks because?
He says he does not have time to leave his current shop where he heals people. His current office, where he's a doctor's office, basically. He doesn't have time to go anywhere, and he doesn't have enough assistance to continue healing people while he's not there.
So, how much are you looking for? If I'm just talking to him.
Well, just that guy.
I'm willing to negotiate, maybe.
He says, up front for that 3 months. I see, I normally get about 20 gold every month in profit. That's what I get here.
Man, out of character. You didn't tell me how much money. Blackjack's just gonna decline. Blackjack says, I gotta get an interview. We gotta get interviews. Sorry. But it is a new up and coming startup, and there are likely open positions. But anyway, if I find any more information, I may swing back by again, actually. How about that?
Well, if you're in town, I can talk business here, but I cannot go there.
Excellent. I will maybe come back later. But anyway, I've got two that are interested in going to see this nice place. I'll see you later.
Nice.
And, yeah, that was a little less tactful than usual. I'm getting a little sleepy.
No, it's nice place. It's a burnt-out mansion. Oh.
Well, it is a nice place, or it's going to be a nice place. Blackjack was saying that, honestly. It's also nice from the standpoint of it's a growing place and there'll be opportunities to heal more people, but the more he thought about saying it that way, the more it's like, yeah, people are going to get hurt all the time. You get to work all the time.
There's anyway, no downtime or no vacation.
That too.
You don't get paid for overtime.
Oh, yeah.
Anyway... yeah, Blackjack does that for basically 2.5 days or whatever.
Yeah, that's how long it took you to find those total of three people.
Yep.
Okay, so you get a runner finds you and says, hey, they're ready.
All right.
Discuss the deal.
Where at when?
Now.
Now. All right, take me there. I put on my nice traveler's clothes.
You head on down.
I forgot I had those.
Get in the office. There's two people sitting at the table. They motion for you to sit down.
I sit down.
He says, okay.
Do I recognize either of them?
Yes, one of them is the guy you were talking to the other day.
Okay. What race is he?
What race is he? He is a half-elf.
Okay. And what's the other guy?
The other guy's a dwarf.
I like that it's a half-elf because it means he's very difficult to convince and he's difficult to be charmed. So that's cool.
They are the best negotiators.
Indeed. Why do you think
and he's a negotiator? And I hate that you brought a dwarf to the table, but anyway. Okay. You're dirty, DM. Anyway, let's keep going.
Would a dwarf be any better or worse?
No, the dwarf is there because he's the person who looked at the building. That's the
So you can't bullshit him.
Yeah, so I can't bullshit him. I'm not going to try to bullshit him, but I've got other information that they don't have still, so I'm good to go.
So based upon the report my friend here has given me, he says there's been extensive damage to the building over years. Looked like it was sacked at one point, and over that it's just been years of neglect, and it's fallen mostly into ruin. So
I disagree with the mostly into ruin portion, but continue.
Based upon that, if the keep were in better condition, we could offer you more, but unfortunately, it's in such a poor condition. we can only offer you, right off the bat, about 13,000 gold.
Blackjack kind of leans back in his chair and looks to the left and looks into the right. 13,000 for a half-built keep?
That's the extensive damage.
It's pre-made for you. It's already there. You have a full foundation. You have walls that are already set up. For the most part, you'll have to rebuild some of the walling, some of the edges, you know, spackle a little this, a little that. Out of character, I can't say that without laughing.
Roll a persuasion check.
Okay.
Oh. Yeah, it did kind of shift gears a bit quick there.
Cool.
He says, well, you know, you do have a point. The foundation is very solid. Everything that's there is not in danger of falling down. Mostly it's just a very large repair job. So
I would consider it a very large, almost finished job. You know what I mean? Rather than a repair job, it's just a new fort that's not done yet.
Let's see. Based upon what's needed specifically for that.
He has one of those calculators that's making those noises.
No, he has an abacus that's making that.
16,000.
You're killing me here. You're killing me.
One of the other aspects is that it is indeed in the middle of the forest. There's no really accessible roads to it. We'll have to cut a road to the keep to actually repair it.
Yeah, but there's plenty of people available to help do the work right nearby in Phandalin. And I don't think that they're going to charge you very much to help do that.
You do have a point there. Just a second. He goes off to the side and starts talking with the dwarf. After a few minutes, he comes back. Well, based upon what you've stated, you're correct. We can go to Phandalin. We can hire people there, not only to help with the road building, but possibly with the construction. As there are miners there, they certainly are capable individuals. They probably enjoy doing some other work as well.
You're absolutely right. I'm glad you thought of it.
As such...
Blackjack hands him the shovel.
As such, we would be willing to raise the price to 17,000. But I can't really go higher than that.
I think you can. And I've got some other good reasons why. So let me ask you about this. So, yes, if you take the fort by itself, it has a specific value. And he kind of waves his hands around a little bit, not like sarcastically, but just a general little bit. It has a specific value by itself, but over a long period of time and over a decent investment, it has a much more valuable return on its investment. So what we also did, me and my associates, we went and there is a mine over there. We helped a small mining firm seize said mine from its I don't really know a better word, but it's evil inhabitants. And they will begin production yet once again soon. They'll begin their operations soon. And the keep there will surely incentivize people to go work there. Likewise, since it's right next to Phandalin, if you're not familiar with Phandalin, they have this so-called miners exchange. It is a very profitable business that will likely send a lot of business your way. So this is just one example where there's more to this keep than just the value of a keep. So you're talking people feeling safe, people feeling secure, people wanting to go to work to Phandalin because they know that the keep is, it's not even a day away. It's a fort. It's something there to protect them as well to notify Neverwinter.
Roll a persuasion check.
Okay.
As well, you have a very good point there. I'll have to go discuss this with my superiors. If you'll wait here just a few minutes.
I'm plenty patient. I look at the dwarf and I say, so what's your name, man?
Stan.
Nice to meet you, Stan. And Blackjack takes off his glove and offers the hand to shake it to him.
He shakes your hand.
My name is Stan. I'm little man.
And he puts the glove back on. He says, I'm sorry I didn't introduce myself before. I forgot. I got excited and unsure, and it was implied of me.
That's okay.
So how long have you been working for the city?
Oh, quite some time. Mostly I form in on construction jobs. Sometimes they have me go out and make sure things are built right, which is what happened here. It gives me some extra money.
I would like to insight if he is implying anything by saying it gives me extra money.
Okay. You're pretty sure he means that he does this as a side job for the city other than his normal job.
Okay. He's not dropping any hints or anything.
No.
Okay. Just checking. Because I so totally would have bribed him to change his mind. Like, I was like right there. I was like, man, over. But anyway.
I mean, it's a nice keep. Well, I mean, it could be nice, I should say.
That it is. It is indeed a nice keep.
I mean, I'm all for you getting however much you can. It doesn't change how much I'm getting.
Blackjack says, that's a shame. And he kind of shrugs. So, where are you from, Stan?
As you ask this, the other guy walks in.
Oh, thank God.
The first guy. He sits down and says, all right, I've discussed this with my superiors, and I've managed to get the limit raised to 18,000.
To 18?
To 18,000.
Blackjack sighs. Kind of looks around for a moment. And he thinks real hard. He sits back in his chair and scratches his chin. Blackjack says. So. Out of character, I gotta think for a moment. Sorry. My contacts are killing me in there, so they're really distracting all of a sudden. Did I mention that within the next, I don't know, maybe 6 months, that they're increasing the size of the town by building a clinic as well?
Oh, no, didn't know this.
They're increasing. Kind of it's a medical clinic for anybody who gets hurt. So not only are they setting up the mine, but they're preparing for workers already.
Oh, so this clinic would be, is it specifically for the miners, or could anybody go?
Anybody could go. It's good for, I mean, it's really just good to help build that little town of Phelandale, and it's a tool, it's a catalyst for expansion and growth in Phandalin. If you guys keep your keep here, if this keep is your keep, the Phandaliners may recognize Neverwinter's, I'd say, loose dominion. And again, that's good news. That's good PR, right? Good relations with the public and with the citizens.
Question I would be concerned about is, could the soldiers and whoever else happens to be at the keep, could they come to the clinic?
I don't see why they couldn't. I'd have to talk with my associates, but I would, and my associates are quite far away. I don't really want to waste the time, but I would suppose that they could.
I suppose the better question would be is, would they get a discount?
We've talked about this thing in the past, and it's been discussed, but we don't really like to mix government with our business affairs. We don't think that it is a ethical thing to do. I don't know if that's a great question to ask, mister.
Well, okay. One other thing I could ask about, I should ask about that is, how many people could this clinic service at once? How many injured people are we talking about here? Because if it could only serve, if you could only have maybe two people in there at once, that might not be enough to really help with any.
If I had to estimate the number of people offhand, we didn't have the plan of the building quite set. But if I had to make an estimate, I would estimate between 10 and 20 people.
Oh, that many?
Yes. Oh. I would estimate between 10 and 20 people could be continuously cared for. I am currently looking in town right now, in fact, for capable people, and I've found two so far from Neverwinter, and possibly a third. We'll see.
Somewhere in Phandalin, Lazarus breaks into a cold sweat. 10 to 20 people. Oh, God.
Out of character, if you have two people and they're servicing these many people a day, I mean, it's like nothing. You've got the basement. You've got a building.
If you look at the plans that you already put out, wherever they are.
I think the plans may be even bigger. Remember, you have the basement.
It's not just that. The plan that was
I saw that
made.
Picture, but I didn't really take that into account because I never was told anything in character.
Oh gosh, where is it?
Let's scroll way what? Up somewhere. There maybe is. In handouts. I don't know.
Yeah, the one I made is the one I'm going to look at here. Going according to that, there's four like actual rooms, but that doesn't mean you can only service four people.
Yeah, and you can put two people in each room, and you can also use the basement, and that's only one floor. I don't know.
If there was overflow, you could use a lot more of the building.
Yeah.
We could. Yeah. And with two people actually running the clinic, we'd be able to do it easily.
Oh, yeah. As far as, no, this is more like number of people a day, not.
Oh, okay. I was like.
Not all at once.
No, and I'm considering the place being like full continuous care. That's where I'm considering. So I said 10 to 20 continuous care.
It would be of type.
Anyway.
You could do that, yeah.
I don't know. That's what I tell him. And I'm not lying. I'm just telling you what I think.
No, I'm telling you, yeah, you could do that. It would just be a bit crowded. But it says, all right. You notice he has been
writing down. It's a sizable operation. Surprisingly sizable.
He has been writing down. So what you've been saying. He says, all right, well, I will see what I can do with this. I'm afraid I'll have to leave you alone for a period of time again.
Okay, that's fine.
He gets up and leaves.
I go back talking to the dwarf. So, where you come from? I'm sorry we were interrupted.
Oh, I'm from up north. One of them dwarf mining towns up there.
Which one?
Making me look at maps.
Is it a mining town, or are you from one of the holes up north?
Oh, it's a mining town up there. But I have to find the map quick.
I am the player that all the DMs hate. I ask too many questions. I want too many details.
I'm fine with you asking this question.
I know, but I do that to my other DM too right now. I ask him a lot of questions and he chugs a bunch of time when he can, and he rolls dice for everything, I swear.
Well, if you go everything in the DMG, you should roll your dice for almost every decision you make.
No, I don't think you should. It's a waste of time. You'd be surprised. And I don't even think that the dice that he rolls actually does anything half the time. I think he just does it to feel like he's rolling the dice.
It is that way sometimes.
Either that or he's saying, I'm going to think this beforehand, and then he rolls the dice to see what it ends up being. And it's like, well, you could have just decided kind of randomly. Nothing's random, but either of the dice.
Oh, I'm from Iron Master.
Oh, I've never been to Iron Master, though.
Oh, it's so way up north up there.
What landed you here in Neverwinter, so far away?
Oh, well, I was just doing some mining up there for the most part. That was my living. But I always had an interest in construction and architecture. So I went to visit Luskin at one point and heard that Neverwinter was needing some people for construction. I decided, hey, that'd be a nice break from mining. What came down here, got a job, and I just haven't ever left.
Oh, sounds good then.
Don't forget, you're here forever.
What?
He is not the Simpsons.
Anyway, he says, well, if you've been here that long, it sounds like it's been a pretty good place to work.
Oh, it's been quite profitable for me. A lot more profitable than working in a mine.
You said your name is Stan, right?
Yep.
And you said it's very profitable for you, Stan, right?
Being here working for the city like this, yes, it is quite profitable.
That's good, Stan.
And the guy walks in.
Out of character. My character's putting the squeeze. All right. He walks in.
I have talked to them and talked to them and talked to them. And I have managed to get one more raise on the price. But I am not going to get any more after this. They're kind of at their limit. So I've managed to get them to raise it with what you were talking about with the clinic. They said they would raise the limit to 20,000.
Yeah, that's where I was going with this. Yes. It sounded like you had a little hook on it here.
If you give a 5% discount to anyone who works there at your clinic.
What if anyone who works there, what if we just lowered the price 5% to everyone?
Yep.
I think that would count, yes.
Okay, we can do that, but I still don't think you have the price right here. I seriously don't think you have the price right. You're forgetting an external factor that you're not including.
And that would be?
That would be a bit of a wild card. Yeah, so this is one external factor. Are you familiar with this man by the name of Sigmund Frost, right?
Oh, Jesus Christ!
I'm pulling all the strings.
He's pulling all the strings.
I'm pulling all the strings. I'm pulling all the stoppers, all the doodads.
Oh, the Paladin? Yeah, I know him.
The Paladin? Yeah. So I kind of just quickly flash the card. I say, I'm, friends with him. You know that, right?
Oh, he gave you that?
Puts the card back. Yes, personally. Quite obvious that Blackjack is not lying here.
He put quite a bit of trust in you, giving you that card.
He does put a bit of trust in me and my associates. You know, is that not worth any more than 20,000 gold?
Well, you see, you guys are associates with him. You are an associate with him. I presume your associates that you helped you with the key. So they're also known.
We're employed by him. Yes, we're employed.
Oh, you're employed by him.
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that. You should have mentioned that earlier.
Oh, I'm sorry. I tend to forget things when people, you know, they walk out of the room, they change the price, and they do it again and again and again.
So, you're a part of his adventuring guild, I imagine? The Shadowhunters?
Yes.
Well, taking that into account, I can probably do something.
And what do you think you can do with that?
I don't know. Make a persuasion check.
Man, my freaking eyes are killing me, so I'm like halfway squinting at the screen.
Well, let's see.
I'm sorry, but I keep thinking of the time when you, that half-elf said, oh yeah, and this, and I'm like, yeah, sure, they can also help build.
Like, yeah, just dig that hole.
Yeah.
Just dig that hole.
He's digging his own hole, but that's fine. Anyway.
Lazarus has to chop down, like, 400 trees anyway, so might as well make a road with it.
Like, fucking, you get back and you tell us what happened here, and we're just gonna be like, oh my god.
There's gonna be a lot of facepalming, and also,
why a lot
I don't
of
facepalming?
I don't understand. I'm using all the leverage. 5%
discount to everybody, even though he just asked for employees of the fort to get it.
Yeah, I know. I know what I'm doing here, and I'll explain when I get back.
I mean,
I know what he's doing.
I appreciate somebody understanding.
Yeah.
All right. You're the best. You're the best. Like, I totally, like, really got that one in there. That one was, like, bazing.
We could give them all a member's card, and then if they lose it, we don't give them replacements.
That wasn't it, but I'll explain it Blackjack will explain it when he gets back.
Be the dick.
Waiting on the potato for the Sigmund Frostwright gold card.
Okay. So you are his associate. You're willing to sell to the city.
I still haven't pulled my ace yet, too. I still have an ace in my sleeve.
You shouldn't say things like that.
Well, that's out of character. I'm saying that out of character. I trust that you're not going to use out of character knowledge to try to screw me over. Maybe I shouldn't. I don't know.
Okay, well, based upon that, I know I could get them to raise it another 1,000. With all previous conditions applying.
Okay. So I have had my own, and I don't mean it to sound like this, I guess. Maybe that's not the best way. But anyways, my own friend looked at this building. He's also a dwarf. He is quite wise. He has done a pretty good job of estimating it as well. And I think based on his description, in combined, also with this last opportunity, I will mention briefly in a moment, is that I believe that the price is that we can settle on, that I've talked to my fellow friends and myself, my coworkers, we've been able to settle on 22,000. And the reason is that this property is valuable, like I've said, for all of the other reasons, but I'm giving you, Neverwinter, the first stab at buying it. if I can't sell it to Neverwinter, if I can't make that sell, then I'm going to go to Lord's Alliance. And we voted on it, my crew members and I, we voted on it together, and we determined that we would like to give Neverwinter the first stab at purchasing it. If it came down to it, then we would perhaps visit other clients. So no other clients even know about this deal. There's no bid right now. We're not pitting anybody bidding against each other or anything. So I would really like to sell it for 22, and I'd hope you consider the possibility, the likelihood of us considering Lord's Alliance as a specific and different and unique individual purchasing entity besides Neverwinter.
He motions to the dwarf to go off to the side with him. You notice he's making large hand motions.
Are they like frantic hand motions?
Yeah.
I'd like to try to infer what he's talking about. Or can I hear him? Is he saying stuff or just making hand motions?
Well, he's saying stuff.
He's saying stuff. Can I hear him?
You can try to. He's actually talking very quietly. But you can try to.
I'm going to try to hear him as hard as I can. And then I would like to try to infer what he's saying as hard as I can.
Okay, basically I'll just tell you basically what he's saying inference wise. He's basically saying he doesn't really want to go out and talk to the guys again because they're already mad with him. But based upon what you said, it would be worth another. So he's more arguing with the you that 1,000 or not.
But I wait patiently.
After a few minutes, he comes back and sits down. He says, okay, we'll do it. 22,000.
Pull up the paperwork. You have yourself a deal. And I pull out the title just to show him that I have the title, because I don't know that I actually ever did that.
He pulls out a folder and opens it up, fills out some information, puts an X and says, sign here.
I read the paperwork very carefully to be sure that there are no tricks. And
give me an investigation check.
An investigation check, you said? Do I have any special abilities that I can use here? My eyes hurt. I can't read anything. That's ironic.
That's a penalty.
Yeah. I would like to use my knowledge of forgery. And...
Yeah, you probably could. Yeah, sure, go ahead.
And... I'm very paranoid, right, actually, at the moment.
But you cannot use your forger's kit.
No, I'm not using my forger's kit. I'm using my knowledge of forgery. I'm using my skill, my proficiency in forgery. I don't know why I would use my forgery kit.
You just turn around and forge a better deal. Like, yeah, here you go.
I write it down. I change it up.
The proficiency is with the kit.
Okay, I think this is all I get. So I'm going to pray to God.
I thought you got more than that. But you don't find anything hinky with it.
Okay. I don't find anything hinky with it.
And the amount on there is 22,000 gold to be paid to you personally.
Yeah.
And...
Blackjack says, I would like the gold beside it with it.
Do what?
Blackjack says, I would like the gold beside it with it.
You mean you want me to give you the gold right now?
When I sign this. I want the gold when I sign this.
Oh, okay. Well, give me a minute. I have to go get it.
Oh shit, balls, Batman.
I don't have it with me.
Bluff called.
No, not that. Not bluff called. Yeah, not that. I just realized something, you guys.
Set.
You can't carry all of it?
Yeah. Why didn't you ask for it to be delivered? Jesus.
He comes in. He doesn't have a wheelbarrow. He actually has a small chest. And there are two guys carrying the chest. They set it on the table.
Yeah, Blackjack has 8 strength. I'll totally be able to carry that home.
I look at the chest and I open it up. Is it filled with platinum? What's in there?
It would still be 2,200 platinum.
2,200 platinum, it's not, right?
It's not all.
What?
It's not all platinum. He says, okay, we could put 10,000 of it into platinum. So there's 1,000 platinum in here. But the other 12,000 is still gold. And obviously, as you can see, that is not terribly low.
And there's 12,000 gold. I gotta do the math on this. Blackjack thinks for a minute. He says, I'm still not willing to give this up until knowing that I'm getting out of here. So let me go arrange. Let me go arrange for, Blackjack's starting to think about the logistics.
Tell you what. How about this? We will give you a bag. You can put all this in. It doesn't weigh that much.
What?
You can just take it with you.
What are you talking about?
Wait, actually, how much weight does this gold have?
That's what I'm looking at right now. Like, holy shit, balls back. Divided by 5... It's got to weigh 600 pounds, just the gold, and then the platinum weighs...
Yeah, 50 gold per pound.
20. Oh, never mind. The gold weighs... Oh, yeah, it does, I think. My eyes are screwing up, and it's really annoying. So, 2... So, divide by 2 is 6. No. Divide by 5, I get 2... I carry the 2 is 4, and then O, and that's divided by 50. So the gold itself is 240 pounds, and the platinum is 20 pounds. So that's 260 pounds total.
I want to look at
what?
I have to look at something.
I think I know what you're looking at. I'm not going to take my time to go look. You can put a whole person in a bag, by the way. It actually says that somewhere.
So, out of character, am I right in assuming that 5% off for everyone is actually you just not lowering the prices at all and saying it's 5% off?
Yes! Yes!
Because that's the only way I can see that making sense.
Yeah, because if we don't have a price established, then...
Yes, exactly, you guys.
Okay.
It's so beautiful.
So, but it's less than 500 pounds. That's the point.
What?
The gold? Total weight of all gold and stuff is less than
500. Yeah. Yeah, well, so what about it?
Okay.
What does that mean?
If you give us 1,000 of the gold back, I can give you an item.
How about 500?
No, sorry, not 1,000. That's not the right number. I was thinking 4th edition.
I may have screwed up the number then with my saying 500. He may say, okay.
No, I mean out of character, I screwed up the number.
Oh, so he's going to say something different.
Yeah.
And Blackjack's such a cool dude that he's going to take it out of his cut.
200.
Take out 200 of the gold?
200, just 200 of the gold will give you an item.
That can carry it all.
That can carry it all.
And weigh what for me?
It'll carry it all, and it'll weigh... It will weigh 15 pounds.
Oh.
But it can carry, like, 100 pounds.
Damn. That's like
okay.
A sack of holding.
Is it out of character? Is it a handy haversack, or is it a bag of holding?
No, that is actually the 5th edition bag of holding.
Okay. Blackjack says,
thinks about it for a minute. He said, so then the total amount of gold that you give me will be 21,800?
Yes, 21,800.
I think that's a fair deal. Just, you know, put it in the bag in front of me so I can see it.
Well, I have to go get the bag. I don't have it here.
All right, I'll wait here, kindly.
Yeah, he leaves, comes back a couple minutes later with a satchel.
All right.
It's a very nice-looking satchel. And he opens it up, shows you that it's empty.
Okay.
Then he takes 200 gold out, sets it aside, and him and the other two guys, the two guys he brought in the chest, just start shoveling money into it.
They lift the chest and start pouring the gold in.
I can imagine this thing just being, like, stamped, like it's from the Neverwinter gift shop.
Made out of plastic, no.
Plastic bag of holding.
They're super careful with the 200 gold, and they just start throwing the rest into the bag haphazardly.
No, they're not doing it haphazardly.
Just pouring it in. I can see them just pouring it in. Somebody holding the bag, and then they're both. It
takes,
like,
about 10 minutes for them to put it all in.
Jesus!
I would reach in, grab a handful of gold, and just try to be sure that it's real gold. This is not bullshit. I've never seen this amount of gold in my life. I don't know what to do with this.
Well, based on weight, it's right.
Based on weight, it's right. Okay, that's fair enough.
And it looks right.
I would like to make an insight check, I guess. Okay. I'm so dumb.
All the gold you look at looks genuine to you.
Okay. Blackjack would like to do a thing. Holy crap. Blackjack would like to do a thing. This is actually not occurred to me until just now. Blackjack will say this. He say, I would like to do one maybe last check before this deal is done. So the money is in the bag here, right? Yes. You're waiting for me to sign, right?
Yes, waiting for you to sign, and then I can sign, and then it'll be done.
Done, and you've got a receipt for me too, right? Yeah.
Okay. Yes, it's on the flip. It's a
carbon copy. But... great. So
we each have a copy. We'll have a copy of the deal.
I'm going to do this. I'm going to make sure that. So for me, it's obvious that this is a very large piece of land, a large, valuable property, and I want to be sure that I am really getting what I pay for. So I don't imagine that you are somebody who easily gets offended. Is that accurate if you're working in this kind of environment?
Oh, people say all sorts of weird things to me. I mean,
all right. Well, I'm not saying anything weird to you, but I clap my hands and I say, Agama will reveal the truth to me. And I cast Zone of Truth.
You cast Zone of Truth. Yes, okay. That seems fair.
And he says, so that money in the bag is of the amount that I've requested, and it is the correct amount. Is that the truth?
That is the truth. All that gold, all that platinum, it is all real. It is all for you in this deal.
Okay. And this paper here that signs it off to Neverwinter, this is not a forged document, and there are no tricks and no questions about it. Is that correct?
It is an absolutely legitimate document from the offices of Neverwinter, and there is nothing in it attempting to trick you out of any money.
Okie doke. Well, everything seems in order then, and he disperses the Zone of Truth. Poof. And
you notice the guy, this thing kind of seems kind of the standard, you know, for the par.
What?
With the Zone of Truth.
What?
It didn't seem that he minded it at all, almost like it happens a lot.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I just, being honest though, like if somebody come up and do that to me, I'd be offended by it, and I'm not trying to offend, but that's why I prefaced that, basically. All right, so, then he takes off his glove once again, offers to shake the half-elf's hand.
He shakes her hand. Back.
It's not Clifford. It's not Griffin. It's
Garfield.
Garfield. There you go. He says, "Well, Stan, it was a pleasure to meet you as well." And now he takes the bag and he puts it on his side in a suitable pouch.
You signed it, right?
Not yet. He's pulling out a pen. But it's actually, the funny thing is, he could have asked Blackjack some questions in the Zone of Truth, but he didn't. I was wondering if you're going to ask him any questions. I was really hoping, please don't ask me a bunch of questions. Please don't ask me a bunch of questions. But anyway, he takes the pen up from the table. He signs the thingy. And he hands it to him.
Then the steward signs it.
Yep.
Pulls the papers apart. Hands you the bottom one. You can see both signatures on it. It
Excellent.
Is an exact copy.
Excellent. I put it away. And I say, it's been a pleasure doing business with you. I will be sure to tell Sigmund Frostwright that you have done well by him. And as you as well, Stan. So... thank you very much. And if you guys are ever in the need of any private investigative work, please let me know. My name is Blackjack. I am mainly in Waterdeep, but I may be traveling around here in the future. So, yeah.
Well, it was a pleasure doing business with you, Blackjack.
All right. See you later. What?
We'll probably get some people out there fairly quickly to start reconstruction.
Excellent. See you later. All right, I get back to town.
You get all the way back to Fandy.
Fanderberderp.
With two people for the interview.
Yep, of course.
Two people for the interview.
I didn't know how many people you wanted. I just saw one, so I was like, I better get as many as I can, and then that's how I got it. So I bring two people.
Two should be good, and I interview them. And
one is a cleric. And the other is a herbalist.
Okay.
You got to do the interview. Maybe they're bad at their job.
Potato, are they bad at their job? Like, it's like 1 a.m. I don't want to stay up for, like...
Just to make sure sorts, they're both good at their job and are both willing to work.
Oh, by the way, I'm going to split the money.
I'll come up with numbers later.
Okay. I split the money since it's 22... Right, 22 divided by 4 is 5.
5,500.
That's what I thought. And then what I'll do is I get 5,300 and everyone else gets 5,500 because I'm taking that money of the bag out and I'm keeping my word about the amount of money that I got for it.
Lazarus stares at the money. Holy fucking shit!
Except all of the money that I got, basically, the way I'm splitting it up is such that I myself am getting...
most of the gold?
Nope, most of the platinum.
Fuck you, Mr. Bag of Holding!
Yeah, but the nice thing about it for you guys... Oh, that's a decent point. I would just split it equally. That's difficult to do.
I'll take all the gold pieces. I can carry things, so whatever.
Yeah.
Well, on one hand, I don't need a bunch of gold because I need to buy stuff sometimes, but I really don't unless I'm in Neverwinter. So I could see you guys needing the gold more than the platinum because if you guys got to buy stuff or whatever, move stuff around, it's going to be easier with the gold. Plus, you can store the gold when you get the building built. You can have a little vault or something. So, yeah. I'm going to do the, since we get 5,500 each, I'm going to just go ahead and take 550 platinum. That way I don't have to carry 11 pounds of stuff.
You know, when we started playing this, I did not intend for you guys to do stuff like sell Cragmaw.
I didn't really expect this to be like real estate agents either, but here we are.
I expect you guys to go, oh, that was nice, and leave and never think about it again.
They're going
to
retire. We're going to be done in 2 weeks.
We could retire now.
It's going to be Sarkam on his own picking flowers.
And then the world ends. Oh. Well, the world as you know it.
Well, that's because, you know...
That's only a problem for poor people.
I think that's because I'm playing the D&D. And I'm playing a character that would do that. I'm playing a character that would, like, be like, oh, we could sell this.
Dude, when we get to level 20, we're basically going to be like, roll up to the final boss in our Rolls Royce, and then, like, come out of the car wearing sunglasses. All of us have BFGs, and then we're just like, okay, Bahamut and Tiamat working together somehow, because we paid both of you off with insane amounts of money that don't even... that aren't even logical, because we have a money dimension now that's just money.
Money dimension.
Dimension of holding, where we have all the gold and platinum.
Whenever you need money, you just open a portal to the money dimension.
It doesn't grow on trees, it grows in its own dimension.
Nana, have a dimension of platinum, and that's also where, like, platinum dragons like to hang out. And they're all at your demand.
There's only one platinum dragon.
He's at your commands.
You have a god at your command?
Bob, it says, bitch, please.
Then we pay him off.
We pay him and off.
Then we say, bitch, please.
Bob, it's like, damn, I've got a price too, I guess. Holy shit.
And he's just like, well, what you need murdering?
On one hand, I am a god. On the other hand, that is a lot of money.
Bob's like, I guess everyone's got a price. I guess I'll go kill Paylor now, I guess. That makes sense.
Oh, geez, us having our, like, own tall scene where, like, gods fight for our amusement.
I will tell you, at level 20, you will not be able to fight gods.
That would be dumb.
At level 30, though.
There is no level 30 yet.
Yet.
That is why I said yet. I fully expect there to be a level 30 in about a year or so.
Even so, this is Forgotten Realms. Killing gods is difficult if you're not a god already.
Yeah, and usually, even if you kill a god, you really only ever kill its aspect. It's still there.
Well, you have to kill their aspect, go to their home, and then kill them there.
And you also have to already be immortal before you can kill them, and then it's like, there's just too much stuff. It's too much bureaucracy.
Okay.
I think I remember reading something about Forgotten Realms, but there's an explicit rule in Forgotten Realms that you cannot kill a god without the help of another god, or at least demigod.
Yeah.
It's more along the lines of, you won't. You can try. It ain't gonna work.
So, how long exactly did it take for him to do all that?
Probably week and a half.
Yeah, about a week and a half.
Okay, for Albrecht and for... Lazarus, and I'll cover this with Dragonborn with Sarkum later, but the thing I told you over Discord that one day, you now know that information.
What?
You don't know it!
Okay. That's weird.
In the meantime, Sarkum became 30 years old, and Blackjack became 44.
Alright, 44.
Basically, on Blackjack's 44th birthday, he got, like, $55,000.
$5,500.
Okay, $5,500 and a bag of holding, pretty much.
Or $5,300 and a bag of holding. Yeah, I kind of paid for it.
What's that for?
Birthday for you.
Is that for... Seek?
Yes.
What?
He needs to roll a 31, not a 30.
Oh. There you go.
Sieg's birthday happened 4 days. It was Sieg's birthday the day that we met him, pretty much.
And you'll never guess his age.
10. 10,000. 1,000.
He is not an ancient dragon. If he's an ancient dragon, why on earth would he deal with you guys? He'd just go kill gods himself. Those things are virtually unstoppable.
It is... Seed's birthday.
See, now, wait. What was the... Let me look at the monster manual here.
Guess I need to add 530 platinum.
We didn't get that much platinum.
See, an ancient silver dragon has a equivalency of 25, so...
So, how much EXP did we get, Potato?
Did we get enough for level 5?
How much experience do you need right now so I can just tell you yes or no?
1,100.
Oh, you're a little bit shy.
Are you sure? Are you sure we're a little bit shy and not just at it to make it nice and even?
Quite frankly, you're going to be just at it because I want you guys to be level 5 when you start other stuff.
Okay, good.
Because I've already designed all the encounters to start at level 5.
Thank you.
Meaning that, including that experience you guys got for everything else, all those other quests, and you guys are now all going to be at level 5.
Sweet. Exactly.
Exactly at level 5. So you get all your extra powers. The warrior can now do 5 attacks a turn.
5 attacks a turn.
I can only do 2.
No, no. You get to do 2 per attack action, and if you have an offhand weapon, you get an additional.
Oh, well, I don't have an offhand weapon.
Okay. You could do 4, right?
Yeah.
If I action surge.
With his action surge, he could do 4.
Yeah, but that's 4 once per short rest.
Yep.
That's true.
Rah, 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 rah!
Okay, guys, I need a nap.
All right, good night.
I still have to heal, so.
Let's see here.
I'm going to go ahead and level up Zing just a moment.
That's unfortunate.
That was my to heal, because I was still down.
Oh, that was your heal. That's right, you don't get a
D10. Yeah, I do.
You do?
Yeah, fighter.
Oh, we have to roll for health. I hate this part.
Average!
That's my health.
That's not bad for average.
Flash, roll. Oh, I hate this part. I
that's my health.
1d8.
Oh, really good.
Here we go, guys.
Yes! 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 Yes!
Don't suck as much. Yay!
Hey,
I didn't need to do a GM roll. I got 4 for a total of 9.
So,
okay,
Mike.
Yeah?
Are you taking level 2 rogue or level 4 bard?
Level 4 bard. I'm going bard all the way.
But level 2 rogue gets you hiding as a bonus action and running.
I don't need hidey or running. Like, there's just... We've got 5 people. I haven't needed to run. I have not needed to disengage. And if it's that bad, then I'll disengage with one turn.
You guys were doing easy and medium encounters this entire adventure. You've done 2 hard encounters.
Bring it.
I was going to say that flame skull seems like it should be up there, considering it nearly killed the guy who rolled perfect health as a hill dwarf in one shot.
He's supposed to be able to do that.
Fireball!
And so that's a bag of holding, right?
Yes, that is a 5e regular bag of holding.
Cool.
I will say, someone else in the party has a device that can store more things than it looks, and he doesn't know it.
I think that's the item that of freshness.
No, I told you how much that can store. It can store a regular bag's worth, but it keeps things fresh.
Bag of freshness.
I feel like I know.
Oh, as a side note, you can put dead things in there to keep them from rotting.
Yeah, you said that.
I could... Probably.
They wanted me to do that with the Wraithans, but everybody after that, they're
all mummified. No, yeah.
No.
Okay. So, we'll work for however long it takes, and, during that, like, if we're just doing, like, a fast-forward, Zing and Albrecht will now be proficient in land vehicle.
I'm not that fast-forward at the moment, but yeah.
At the end of the fast-forward, which won't be tonight.
Oh, yeah, no.
I am going to get my health just a sec.
I now know comprehend languages. Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, you took a ritual caster feat?
Oh, good. I was wondering when you were going to take that.
the first chance I could.
Now, here's a thing, Mike. Just so you know, you can't just go casting all scrolls ever.
What do you mean?
You can only cast stuff on the bard list.
Woo! Yeah, I understand. I understand that. Now, if I for whatever reason, have the spell through the secret languages, I can, because it counts as being on my bard list. But well, yeah, I don't think I'm going to take Fireball, so don't worry about it.
It's only those spells, is all I'm saying.
Do I get that at level 3?
No.
Or level 4? No, it's level 6. It's level 6, bard. Level 6, bard.
It's level 6 is when you get that.
Okay.
But, well, that's a pretty good roll.
Hey, I never did my ability score at level 4. So does that mean I can add 1 to any of the 6?
Add 2 to one of them, or 1 to 2 of them. Or take a feat.
Or take a feat, yeah.
Oh, okay.
You have 2 points or a feat. Basically.
Gotcha.
And I mean,
you're a druid, but there are feats that are good for you. There's also good to have stats, depending upon your stats.
Well, if he's a wild shape druid, physical stats won't really help him.
That's one of the reasons I was going to suggest a feat, was because you're probably going to be in wild shape most of the time.
But if he raises his wisdom purely, that might be good too.
Yeah.
It is at 14 already, so I could take it to 16.
That's not a bad idea.
I would just look through the feats and see if there's anything that stands out. If there's nothing stands out, then don't worry about feats.
No, there are some feats that will raise something by 1 point, but there are none that will raise it by 2. So
there, yeah. But well, you may be able to
literally just be better than ability score increase.
Well, yeah, but the nice thing is it gives you a reason to take some feats, because then maybe you take 2 different feats and then it kind of kills 2 birds with 1 stone by taking. And
also,
2 feats.
If your main stat's at an odd number,
yeah,
and you can get a feat that
or an odd main stat is an odd number. It helps your odd number stat.
Like if your constitution was at 15, you could raise it to 16.
Yeah, with like the durable one, I think. Although the durable one isn't that good.
Well, durable raises your constitution. And you get your con modifier again.
You get double con for whenever you get healed.
Oh, it's
whenever you... No, you get a minimum. Your roll for hit dice when you use hit dice to heal is a minimum of like your con mod or something.
Yep. It's not super useful.
It's not super useful, but if you're at an odd one and you don't plan on con for any other reason in the future,
well, but
then just to even it out, that's better than raising con twice.
Why not take resilient then? Con saving throws.